Alright, today we're going to talk about what is a DI box, why you need one, and how to purchase the right model. In the simplest terms, a DI box converts an unbalanced signal into a balanced signal. Now what does that mean? Unbalanced connections, like the one used in this cable, uses only two wires, a hot and a ground, typically used with electric guitars, electric basses, acoustic guitars, keyboards, and so on. Tend to pick up buzz, hum, and even radio frequency interference. Also, signal degradation tends to occur the longer the cable gets. Therefore, the lower your signal level gets, the more it needs to be boosted in the mixer. And the more it gets boosted, the noise floor also increases, meaning all the buzz and hums that the cable picks up along the way is just going to be amplified even more. And this only gets worse with longer cables. What is a balanced signal? A balanced cable, like this one, uses three wires instead. There is a hot, a cold, and a ground. These type of connections eliminate the noise issues by rejecting interference as the signal is carried. You can run these cables hundreds of feet, and the signal still stays clean. This is where a DI box comes in. If you're running an unbalanced signal, and using cables longer than, let's say, 25 feet, ideally you'd want a DI box between your instrument and the mixer. The output of the DI is mic level. It makes it much more easy to be mixed at the console. How do you choose a DI box for yourself? In general, there are two types of DI boxes. One is passive and one is active. A passive DI uses a transformer to convert the signal. Active DI boxes have preamps built into the circuitry. This can help to provide more gain for low signal levels. And because of this circuitry, active DI boxes usually require a 9-volt battery or phantom power from a mixer. The easiest way to choose between the two? If you're using an active signal source, for example, an electric bass with active pickups, or a keyboard, or even electronic drums, therefore, you get a passive DI. If you have a passive signal source, such as an electric bass with passive pickups, or an acoustic guitar with passive pickups, meaning they don't use a battery in it, then you'd use an active DI. So all you have to remember is the opposites. If you have an active source, use a passive DI. If you have a passive source, use an active DI. Are the quality of all DIs the same? Well, no. With DIs, you really do get what you pay for. A good passive DI will have a transformer with good shielding and outer casing to maintain isolation from outside interference, such as the radial JDI passive DI with a Jensen transformer. A good active DI will have circuitry with high headroom in order to avoid clipping from very high signal levels, such as the radial J48. Branching out from passive and active groups, there are DIs that are built specifically for certain tasks. Here are a couple examples taken from the Radial Engineering website. If you are using a piezo pickup without any form or preamp, you will get the best result with the PZ DI, as it has a 10 meg ohm input that will properly load the pickup. If you are recording an acoustic with a built-in battery-powered preamp, then the JD48, which is an active DI, or the JDI, which is a passive DI, would be a better choice. The active J48 will have more reach, somewhat like a condenser microphone, while the passive JDI will produce a smoother sound due to the transformer's natural compression and warm bezel curve. Now, in the case of electric guitars, if you're capturing the sound of the amplifier and loudspeaker, the JDX is particularly effective. Unlike a microphone that changes sound depending on where it is positioned, the JDX will always sound the same, as it is hardwired after the amp. Using a direct box before the amp, meaning straight out of the guitar, will give you a clean guitar sound. If the guitars are recorded this way, it is usually for reamping. The Radial J48 has a 220k input impedance that makes it sound nice with magnetic pickups. This can then be used with the X amp for reamping. Hopefully with this info, you can make the daunting task of buying a DI much easier. If you need more info on the product seen on this video, you can check out www.musicbliss.com.my. As this video comes to an end, I'll flash a few handy charts taken from the Radial Engineering website once again, on which DI boxes to choose based on the instrument that you use.